You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Wednesday, December 11th, 2019. This week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are journeying toward Jesus through the help of the prophets. We're talking about the great prophet Elijah this week, a prophet we read about in the book of Kings. We've already talked about how there was a bad king during the time of Elijah that forced the people to worship a false god named Baal. Elijah went through God's command to the king to give him the message that God was mad, there would be punishments, the queen would die, and there would be 3 years of drought. After this, Elijah fled because the queen was trying to kill him, and God took care of him even through the drought. Crows brought him bread, and a widow made him bread and took care of him, even though she only had enough for one day. But God miraculously filled her oil jug and her pot of flour. Now, after this happened, Elijah's life was still in danger. It was in danger throughout. As I mentioned, not only was the king bad, but his wife, the queen, was quite evil as well. Her name was Jezebel, and she was terribly devoted to the false god Baal. She also had her own army, and she used this army to hunt down Elijah. They went village by village looking for him, determined to kill him. Well, the army never found him, but Elijah, through God's prompting, went back to the king on his own. God sent Elijah back to challenge the false god and to show the people of Israel that he alone was the only God. And we know this is true. There is no God besides our God. So worshiping a false god is simply foolish, a waste of time and evil. Now, Elijah, through God, put on quite an incredible show to show that God is the only true God. So Elijah showed up at the king, and he challenged the prophets of this false god of Baal. He challenged them. He said, "Let's see who the real God is. Let's set up a little test." So here's what they did. They built two altars. And at this time in the Old Testament, it was very common to sacrifice things to a god. For example, even as early as Adam and Eve, after you harvested your food, you would take 1/10 of that harvest, whether it's grain or an animal, and you would burn it up. You would burn it up and send it to God, sort of as a, "You gave me everything, God. Here is something back." Now, we continue to do this when we tithe. When we get our paycheck, we don't take 10% of that in dollar bills and burn it up, although we could. Instead, we give 10% back to the church. 10% saying, "God, you gave me everything. You supplied this job and the skills that I need to do this job, and therefore I give you 10% back." So even though it seems strange that at the time they were killing bulls and setting them on fire as a way to say thank you to God, we do pretty much the same thing when we give 10% of our paycheck back to the church or to those that are in need. So anyways, this was a common practice. So Elijah built two altars, and on both they placed an animal sacrifice. Now, what was usually happened is that this animal sacrifice would be set on fire. The smoke would go up to God as an offering. But Elijah said, "Here's the thing. Let's see who the real God is. The first God that can send fire from heaven and set this sacrifice ablaze without a match or anything from us, well, that is the true God." So he said, "Okay, priests of Baal, you guys go first." Now, at the time, there was over 850 priests of this false god. So they get their sacrifice ready, and they're doing all the praying and singing and begging of this false god that they can. But what happens? Nothing. Nothing happens. Why? Because Baal doesn't exist. It's made up. There's no such God as Baal. There's only one true God, the God of Israel, the God that became man in Jesus Christ. So finally, Elijah says, okay, that's enough. My turn. But just to raise the stakes and make the point even clearer, Elijah first poured water on his sacrifice. Now, what did this do? Well, it made setting it on fire even more difficult. And yet, Elijah raised his eyes to heaven. He knew that his God was the true God, that our God is the true God. And instantly, as he began to pray, fire came from heaven and the entire sacrifice, the entire altar was consumed. Everyone saw, everyone knew Baal was false. And the God of Elijah, the God of Abraham, the God of Moses, the God we still love and adore today, he is the only God. Now, as I told you, Elijah came with a very strong message that the punishment for sin is severe and that God will punish sin. So right then and there, Elijah punished the priests of Baal. They were eliminated. Now, this solved some things in that the worship of Baal pretty much ended, but it didn't solve everything. The queen, Queen Jezebel, was even madder than before. She was furious. She was very devoted to Baal, and instead of having her heart converted, she became even more evil and even more determined to kill the prophet Elisha. So his story continues, and we'll tell the rest of his story tomorrow. But for today, here's what I want you to do. I want you to spend a minute just reflecting on this, that there are so many false gods in our world. We might not have clear false gods like idols or like the false god Baal, but we can worship things like fame, money, prestige. We can worship those things. And by that, I mean, we can put them above God. Anything that we put above God is a false god. So I want you, whether you're in your classroom or with your family, to spend a couple of minutes talking about the various things that you can put above God, things that you can focus on more or love more, and talk about how that is very similar to worshiping an idol.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
I'd just like to say congratulations to all of you Sprouts that have been earning patches. So far, I have mailed out over 500 patches, and I know there's many of you out there earning them still. Remember that you can earn a special patch during Advent for doing the Jesse Tree. You can also continue to earn your Rosary patch, your Challenge patch, and your Scripture patch. To learn more, to print the sheets, to start earning them, simply head to CatholicSprouts.com/challenge patches.